Now, coming to you, not quite live, from Glacier View Junior High Studio C1, here are your anchors for this week's episode of GVTV News, Curtis Alvarado and Zach Carpin.
Good morning, Glacier View. Welcome to this edition of GVTV News. I'm Zach Carpin.
And I'm Curtis Alvarado.
Congratulations goes to all the Glacier View bands, choirs, and orchestra for their outstanding performances during the winter concert series.
They represented GV with wonderful behavior and fantastic sound.
Don't forget there's one last winter concert to be held this Thursday in the Commons. It starts at 7 p.m. Arrive early to assure yourselves a good seat.
The winter holiday season is a reminder for all of us that there are some families who are not as fortunate as others.
Glacier View's recent food necessity drive was a huge success and will help many families out. For more on the story, here's GVTV News reporter Maddie Johnson.
Many students have participated in bringing food and necessities for the food drive.
Why do we do the food drive every year?
That's a good question. So we've been doing the food drive here for the last several years. Each year we pick a different nonprofit to host and make sure that we're spreading out the gifts that we're giving and the donations we are. So this year we are donating our stuff to Santa Cop Program, which is done by the Pierce County Sheriff Department. And they actually serve all of Pierce County, and specifically they serve over 300 families in Puyallup. So we do this because it's impacting kids in our own community.
Who is all involved with the food drive?
So primarily it's FCCLA and the Community Service Club, but we also have lots of other clubs that are helping us this year with the stacking and sorting. So we have like the basketball teams that have come down, Honor Society, Heroes, and other clubs are going to be assisting us with the sorting of all the donations.
Your responsibilities in helping with the food drive.
So, being an FCCLA president, we had to spread the word, like by making posters, and then I also had to go around and collect the food and count it.
Why should GV students care about the food drive?
Because it's a great way to get involved with the school and help out the community at the same time.
Even though we didn't meet our goal of 7,000, we collected many food and necessity items to help the families in need.
Maddie Johnson reporting for GVTV News.
Thanks, Maddie.
The GV robotics team is advancing onto the state semifinals this month.
2 weeks ago, the team participated in the regional qualifying tournament and took home the trophy for mechanical design.
They brought home the hardware due to their creativity, hard work, and dedication. Special mention goes out to Taryn Pickham and Brian Lampert for their hard work on the research project.
Ashley Martinez and Andrew Duncan also worked hard in all areas where help was needed, especially in the team challenge.
The programmers and robot engineers included Sajid Khan, Joseph Jetvig, Carlos Caria, Michael Mueller, Mitchell Hamilton, and Brandon Wargle.
Have you purchased a yearbook yet?
Now is the time to pay and be assured you'll get one when they're distributed in June.
The cost is $20 during December. Go to the main office during lunch and bring exact cash or check made out to Glacier View Junior High.
The official order gets submitted in January right after the winter break, so hurry, you don't want to be left out.
Attention ninth graders, if you are planning on attending Rogers or Puyallup High Schools, you need to get your waiver in before January 10th.
You're welcome to submit your waiver now. Forms are available at Mrs. Wyant's desk in the office.
Heroes team members, please make sure you turn in your permission slip to Mrs. Milam for the Pope Parents Night Out, scheduled this Thursday.
Your help is needed. A great night of fun is anticipated at Pope Elementary. Please get those permission slips turned in ASAP.
There are several clubs and activities scheduled for this week.
The Board Game and Cards Club is in full swing. Join them tomorrow and all Wednesdays after school in room 212.
Intramural pickleball starts today after school in the gym. They will also be playing on Thursday. See Mrs. Massey or Mrs. Woolley for more information.
Film Club meets today after school in the drama room. The club will be finishing up Citizen Kane.
Drama Club will meet tomorrow after school in the drama room. Members are asked to bring their scripts with them, for this is an important meeting.
Stage Tech Club will not meet this week.
Homework Help is canceled until Tuesday, January 13th.
That's it for this week's edition of GVTV News. I'm Zach Carpin.
And I'm Curtis Alvarado.
Have a spicy winter break.
Kenya!
Huh?
Are you cheating?
I cannot see. I'm legally blind. That's my story and I'm sticking to it.
the principal's office! No!
I'm innocent.
So why are you in here today?
All I know is what the teacher said.
What did the teacher say?
He said I was cheating, but I am legally blind.
What? So you're saying you can't see? Can you see?
I can see barely.
You know what? Just go to the ISS room. Seriously, I'm gonna finish this paper. Go to the ISS room. What are you doing?
I'm legally blind.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm good.
This winter, a message from your local GVTV News.